हेलो एवरीवन, माय नेम इज़ नदीम खान. वेलकम टू अनकॉमन लिटरेचर. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अनदर एसे बाय फ्रांसिस बेकन, दैट इज़ ऑफ रिवेंज. आई हैव ऑलरेडी मेड अ वीडियो ऑन अनदर एसे बाय फ्रांसिस बेकन, दैट इज़ ऑफ ट्रूथ. सो इफ़ यू हैव नॉट वॉच्ड दैट, must watch that video as well, so that you will get an idea how Francis Bacon writes his essays. So let us begin. So in this essay, he will talk about the idea of revenge, and we will also find out that whether he is in favor of revenge or he is not in favor of revenge. So let us begin. So the first point which he says that taking revenge makes man same as the enemy. By this he says that if somebody does something wrong with us and in return we also do the same thing, we also cause some harm to the person, so there will be no difference between him and us. So he says that if we are taking revenge, then we both are at the same boat, we both are on the same level. So he says this point at the very first beginning of the essay. If some wrong is done, it should be dealt with law. And he is saying that if some wrong has been done to you, it should be dealt with law. Okay, I believe this point is clear. Move to the second point. He says that if we do not take revenge, then this act makes man superior to the enemy. Obviously, that he has just said this, that if we also take revenge, then there would be no difference between us and enemy. And if we do not take revenge, then this act will put us above our enemy. We will become superior. To forgive is divine. He is saying that the act of forgiveness is a divine one. He says this is an act of an exalted heart. Exalted means elevated, full of values, full of morals. Okay? Then next point is, Solomon said that by ignoring a wrong, a man shows how humble he is. We also should apply this theory in our everyday life, that we should not take every wrong to our heart and we should sometimes let go of some wrong. Wrong is done for financial gain. So in the last point of this page, he says that why people commit wrongs, why do they commit wrong deeds? So the reasons are financial gain, for pleasure, some people also do it for pleasure, or for similar reasons. Okay, but he mentions that do not feel hate for malicious people. He is calling these people as malicious. Malicious are like full of poison, full of hatred, who are always thinking wrong about others. So he is saying do not feel hate for malicious people. We will find out why he says this. Because these people are like thorn, which can only prick or hurt others. So he is saying that these people are like the thorns on flowers. You know, some we have flowers, and with flowers we also get some thorns which can prick us very painfully. So the thorns have this action only to do and nothing else. Similarly, these people only have this act of doing wrong to others and they have no idea of anything else. They only know how to hurt others. Next point, man can take revenge. Now in this point he is saying that man can take revenge only when no law provides any remedy. Okay, when there is no law which can provide some solution. Okay, but at the same time he is mentioning that while taking the revenge, no law should be broken. वी शुड नॉट ब्रेक एनी लॉ इवन इफ वी वॉन्ट टू टेक रिवेंज. नेक्स्ट पॉइंट, इट इज जेनरस टू रिवील द रिवेंज इंटेंशन टू एनिमी. एंड नाउ ही इज सेइंग दैट इफ वी वॉन्ट टू टेक रिवेंज we should not break any law, but at the same time he is also saying that if we want to take revenge, before taking it exactly we have to make the enemy aware about our intention. Why he is saying this? Because he is in favor of repentance, he is not in favor of revenge, and he believes that sometimes the enemy may repent about his misdeeds. So he mentions is that pleasure lies in repentance and not in revenge. It is good to forgive an enemy, but it is unwise to forgive a treacherous friend. So he is saying that it is good to forgive some enemy, but at the same time he mentions that it is unwise to forgive a treacherous friend, because from enemies we expect that they can do something wrong to us, but from friends we never expect these things. But when friends commit such things, so we should very much be careful about these people, so we should not forgive them. But there was some person he has mentioned in his essay, his name is Job. So Job said that if we should also accept wrongs from friends, we expect favors from them. So basically what he wants to say that usually we expect some help from our friends, we expect some favors from them, so similarly we should also be ready to accept some wrongdoings from our friends also. Okay, I am not sure how much you would agree with Bacon or not, but he has said this point, quoting Job's idea. He is in favor of public revenges. Now, what is public revenges? So, he is saying that if somebody wants to take revenge on someone, he should take the revenge publicly. Okay, not in secret, not privately. Because if some revenge is taking place before everyone, before an audience, before public, so it would result as a teaching to the others who may commit some wrongdoings in the future, because they are effective to warn other wrongdoers. Okay, last point which he mentions is he is not in favor of private or secretive revenge, because obviously I have already mentioned the point, because if some act is done privately, no one will be able to know about it. Okay, and there will be no teachings of that. He is not in favor of private or secretive revenge. He concludes by saying that revengeful people live a miserable life. So according to Bacon, the people who believe in taking revenges, they live a miserable life, because they can never be happy. However you are harming others inside, from within, you can never be happy by harming others. So all these points I have just summarized the whole essay. Once you go through the essay keeping these points in mind, you will definitely understand it. So with this I would just mention one thing, that if you want me to make a video on some work of literature, please write me in the comment section and subscribe my channel. Thank you so much.